The Supreme Court requires a certain number of subjects you'll need to be eligible to take the bar exams. In this video, I'll be sharing with you the best way to deal with deficiency units in law school at the least minimum cost in time and effort. Coming right up. Hi, my name is Lex and welcome to Lex in Motion. In this channel, I'll be helping you build your competence, confidence, and capability in law school. Start today by hitting the subscribe button below. New videos are posted every Friday. The Supreme Court requires a certain number of units for you to be eligible for the bar exams. These are subjects that are almost usually incorporated during your college degree. Pero minsan may kulang lang ng isa or dalawang subjects. Here are the 5 steps you'll need to complete these deficiency subjects. First of all, a gentle reminder, kapatid, law school is one of the most arbitrary places you'll ever find, and the rules are almost always never fixed. Meaning, ang evaluation ng tropa mo noong college na pareho mo naman ng course ay maaaring ibang-iba sa evaluation sa'yo. Be patient, be positive, and trust the process. Madaling magalit sa registrar, but try to place yourself in their shoes. Empleyado lang din sila, and they would rather err on the side of caution. They have to play it safe, because once upon a time, may isang law student na nag-file ng case against his law school, dahil buong akala niya ay magbabar na siya. Hindi pa pala, dahil sa isang subject. I won't mention names, but you'll encounter this case in your torts and damages. Step 1. Talk to as many college classmates as you can and their experience with the evaluation process. There is strength in numbers, kapatid. Kung marami kayong nagpapa-evaluate, chances are tutupi rin ng registrar at makikredit din ng mga subjects na medyo alanganin sila. Go through the evaluation process together. Step 2. Enter the evaluation process with a positive mental attitude. Be patient, samahan mo ng konting ngiti. Huwag magpapakita ng attitude dahil kayang-kaya nilang ipitin ang certificate of eligibility mo. Once you've met with your registrar, you'll be given a list of the number of units you need to complete. Currently, the Supreme Court requires that you have units in history, social studies, mathematics, the Rizal course, and of course, English. The usual suspects here are English and Filipino. Yan ang kadalasang kulang, especially if you're coming in from engineering, nursing, or other similar courses. Step 3. Secure your permit to cross-enroll. The permit to cross-enroll is a piece of paper from your registrar signed by the dean's office, giving you the authority to enroll another subject in another school. This is because in theory, during your stay in law school, your dean holds the power of life and death over your academic requirements. Bonus tip, huwag kang sasabay sa pila ng mga summer classes. The best time to do this is 1 month before the final exams para sa summer mo na i-enrollin. The permit to cross-enroll has a validity of a long, long time, usually 1 semester. May bayad man ito pero super mura lang naman, kapatid. Huwag matakot. Step 4. Enroll in AMA Online University. Again, full disclosure time, I am not paid by AMA to endorse them to you. I've used it before and my experience has been super positive. AMA Online is quite inexpensive and the subjects they're offering will usually fit with what your registrar requires. The cost is about 1,000 pesos per unit, plus other fees for the registration. It may seem expensive at first, pero mura na yan, kapatid, if you factor in your pamasahe, yung puyat, pagod at gutom mo na uupo ka sa classroom if you enroll somewhere else. Look for Miss Rachelle Castillo. Tell her you're a law student. Alam na niya yung gagawin because they have packages tailored for law students with deficiencies. Exactly what you need. Payment is done through a bank deposit and you don't even have to go to their office. Kailangan mo lang talaga ipadala sa kanila yung scanned copy ng permit to cross-enroll. Also, ipatingin mo rin sa registrar mo yung mga subjects na kukunin mo. Pag-approved, bayad ka na, kapatid. Step 5, complete the subjects in AMA Online. Malaking ginhawa lalo na sa mga working students ang makompleto ang mga deficiency units nang hindi umaabsent sa trabaho. I was able to complete mine after office hours. Kesa maipit ako sa traffic, I used that time to complete the course. What should you expect with their online courses? Well, not much. If you're looking to genuinely learn to read or write better English, mas marami kang mapupulot somewhere else. These courses are for college students. The material is basic and designed for young people, people who haven't completed their college degrees. To be brutally honest, deficiency units ang kailangan mo, kapatid. Ito ay more or less a formality na kailangan mong daanan tungo sa bar exams. If you need to polish your command of the English language, maraming online courses dyan. But for what it's worth, may marireview ka pa rin dito from your college days. Once you log in, you'll have an overview of the course, ilang hours to complete at ilang modules pa. Every module is presented by someone on video. Pwede mo siyang panoorin, pwede mo ring pakinggan kung mahina ang internet mo. Finally, may required reading materials. Super easy lang naman. The system logs and checks your time that you actually spend reading and learning from them. After every module, may quiz na multiple choice. Huwag kang mag-alala kung bagsak ka kasi pwede namang ulitin. Kayang-kaya mong hatawin ang isang subject in 1 to 2 weeks. But do not use this as an excuse to say, saka ako nagagawin. Madaling maging petics dito, kapatid, but it's going to be very, very difficult to do this while working and going to law school. So take advantage of any spare time you can to do the activities in the module. Step 6, submit your grades to your registrar. Submission of grades is almost usually a registrar-to-registrar transaction. Friends from the academe say this requirement comes from the time when hand-carried grades were altered and forged by students during the 70s and 80s. Minana na lang natin to, complete with signed envelopes and college seals. Again, kakailanganin mo na naman ang tulong ni Ms. Rochelle Castillo. Send her an email and request for the transmittal of your grades. For her to do this, you'll need to make another bank deposit, this time para sa courier service. Give her the address of your school and confirm the arrival of your package sa registrar ng school mo. Bonus tip, once you've completed your deficiency units, make it a point na mag-follow up sa registrar's office. Busy sila lagi kapag graduation and it's very, very easy for them to lose a copy of your grades. Always maintain photocopies of your permit to cross-enroll and the grades you've received from AMA Online. Keep this as your receiving copy. There you have it, kapatid. Deficiency units na makukumpleto mo nang hindi nag-half day sa office at hindi nabibilad sa araw. Thank you so much for watching. If you have more questions, let me know in the comments below. Like and share this video for good law school karma. And I'll see you next Friday.